Missy Higgins, welcome to the program.
Hi, thank you. Thanks, guys. Nice to see your faces.
Oh, it's lovely to see yours too. Thank you very much for speaking to us once more and congrats on the new release. We're actually in the meeting talking about what the right adjective to describe how you sounded in it is, and we settled on determined. What's it about?
Determined to get some music done during lockdown. Determined to do the impossible with small children in the house. What's my new song about? Well, it's a song about... It's a real kind of woman power song, I guess. I felt the weight of all these women who are currently, you know, standing up in Parliament and sharing their stories and being so brave and being unapologetic about their anger. And I was trying to channel them and... kind of living vicariously through them, I guess.
Well, you mentioned a daughter. I assumed it was your daughter, at least a daughter you mentioned in the lyrics. And we know you've got two kids now. Do they understand that, like, mummy's a really big pop star?
No, not at all. Definitely my daughter doesn't. I think my son is starting to realise because... I've just been playing him clips over and over again, just trying to drill it into him. Your mum is famous. She's a really good singer. Trying to just get like a little bit of respect out of him, but it's not really working.
Well, I don't know, because as we were preparing for this interview in the break, we saw him trying to sneak in and out of the room, and you were so lovely saying, close the door, close the door. Is that the voice you use all the time? Because I need to change my voice.
No. I knew you guys were listening. I absolutely knew you were listening. I've been doing way too much shouting at my kids during lockdown. I'm definitely not proud of it.
No, we were listening and recording, Missy. We were hoping for something bigger and more volatile, to be absolutely honest. But, of course, you had one of the most epic pregnancy announcements with Luna. You announced that there's 60,000 people while you were touring with Ed Sheeran. Does that force him to be a kind of honorary godfather?
Oh, yeah. God, I wish. You'd get some pretty good presents for Ed Sheeran as a godfather, wouldn't you? Yeah, that was pretty amazing. With both of my kids, I've done significant touring when I've had them in my tummy. So I like to think, you know, how much music kind of got into them while they were in the womb. And yeah.
Have any of them taken up the ukulele? Because I remember when you were pregnant with your first and I went and saw your concert and you described your tummy as a perfect ukulele shelf.
Yeah, both of them love the ukulele, actually. Being pregnant is an awesome ukulele shelf. It was the most relaxing, because usually it's like sliding down. And then I had a pregnant belly and I was like, oh, this is how you're supposed to play ukulele.
Missy, what can you tell us about the Wildflower Festival?
The Wildflower Festivals are an all-female tour that we're doing around Australia. We've just announced a few dates and they're on sale, I think, October 15th. So, yeah, I'm headlining a bunch of those shows and there's some incredible women involved. Sarah Blasco, Kate Miller-Heidke, Vicky Thorne, Casey Chambers, Deborah Conway, Alice Skye.
Wow.
I just can't believe it's taken this long for Australia to put on an all-women's festival, actually, but it seems like exactly the right time for it.
Missy, other than the Wildflower artists that are already performing, it's an amazing lineup. But if we had open borders, who would you fly in to be part of your dream festival lineup?
Oh my God, that's my daughter screaming at the top of her lungs right now. Sorry about that. It's not a pterodactyl in the house. Who would I share the stage with? I don't know. I mean, I love the Waifs and they're all the way over in Western Australia, but Vicky Thorne from the Waifs is going to be involved in this tour. To be honest, so many of my idols are involved, like Casey Chambers was a massive influence on me as well. So it'd be pretty hard to choose who else I would want involved. I mean, there's just endless amounts of amazing women in this country.
Is your daughter screaming because we asked you to turn off Netflix before this interview because the internet was
a bit shaky?
Yeah.
Both of them were on different separate Netflix streams and I was like, oh, God, I'm going to have to turn it off, aren't I?
Well, Missy's single Edge of Something and tickets to Wildflower are both out this Friday. Head to our website for all the details. Missy Higgins, thanks so much for the chat.
Thanks so much, guys. I should just quickly mention that I have a heap of Somersault Festival dates coming up as well, so check them out. We're trying to make up for lost time, so there's going to be a lot of ticket sales.
So you should. Bring on summer. Awesome. Yeah.
Thanks,
Missy.
Guys. Thank you. See ya.
What a great video, and we've got plenty more, so why not click the subscribe button here? Or is it here? Or is it... It's Sorry, I can't see the button. I'm not wearing my glasses. But you can see it, so you click on it to make sure you don't miss any more content.